Hello students, let us take a new question in the topic of torsion. I am marking this question. Let's read what is given here. A solid circular shaft is to transmit 300 kilowatts at 100 rpm if shear stress is not to exceed 80 newton per mm square. Find the diameter of shaft. What percentage saving in weight would be obtained if this shaft is replaced by a hollow one whose internal diameter equals 0.6 of external diameter, length, material and maximum shear stress being same? This is the question which we have in front of us, in which at first there is a solid shaft, then it is replaced by a hollow shaft, and we have to find how much is the percentage saving in weight when we are shifting from solid to hollow shaft. So let us write the data for this question. It is given a solid circular shaft is to transmit 300 kilowatts, power is 300. So it is 300 into 10 raised to 3 watts at 100 rpm. Speed is given. Next, if the shear stress is not to exceed 80 newton per mm square, Fs value. Find the diameter of shaft. So at first we have to calculate how much is the diameter of solid shaft. The next part of the problem, it is related to hollow shaft. The question is, what percentage saving in weight would be obtained? So we have to find out the percentage saving in weight if this shaft is replaced by a hollow one. It means solid shaft is replaced by a hollow one. Internal diameter equals 0.6 of external diameter. So it is, the relation is, the internal diameter is 0.6 times of external diameter. Length, material and maximum shear stress being same. So the length of solid and hollow shaft, it would be same. The material and shear stress value would even be same. So now with the data available with us, let us try to get the solution for this problem. Here, since power and RPM are given, I will start with the equation of power. Since power transmitted by shaft is given by 2 pi nt upon 60, therefore t is equal to p into 60 divided by 2 pi n. Power is given in the question, it is 300 into 10 raised to 3 watts. Speed is 100 rpm, therefore the value of torque comes out to be 28.65 into 10 raised to 3 newton meter. This torque I'll convert it into newton mm. So we have 28.65 into 10 raised to 6 newton millimeter. So the first step was to calculate the torque. Once we know the torque, we can go on for finding the diameter for the solid shaft. I'll say that by strength criteria, based on strength criteria, the formula is T by J is equal to Fs by R. T value, it is 28.65 into 10 raised to 6. Divided by J value. J for solid shaft, it is pi by 32. D raised to 4. Is equal to Fs. Shear stress is given in the question. It is 80 newton per mm square, 80. divided by R, that is equal to D by 2. From left hand side and right hand side, D gets cancelled. So here I have D cube. Therefore, this D cube would be shifted onto the other side, and I have 28.65 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi by 16 into 80. So if I calculate all terms carefully, numerator upon denominator, and take the cube root, I will get the answer of D as it comes out to be 122.18 mm. Our answer number one. The next part of the question. What percentage saving in weight would be obtained if this shaft is replaced by a hollow one? Now we have calculated the diameter of solid shaft. Next, we have to show how much would be the percentage saving in weight if the hollow shaft is used in place of solid shaft. So let us try to get this. I'll say that since the material length and shear stress is same for both solid and hollow shaft, therefore even the torque value will be same. So I'll say that torque in solid shaft is equal to torque in hollow shaft. The torque in solid shaft is given by pi by 16 d cube into fs, that's for solid shaft, is equal to the torque in hollow shaft is given by pi by 16 capital D raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4 upon d into fs. Now since I am equating the torque on both the sides, as I see shear stress value is same, so fs will get cancelled out, pi by 16 and pi by 16 will get cancelled out. This diameter of solid shaft we have calculated just now, the value was 122.18 whole cube is equal to capital D, I'll keep it as it is, in place of small d the relation is given. Small d is 0.6 times of capital D upon capital D. Therefore, if I calculate the terms here, I will get, here I have d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 will give me d raised to 4 upon d. It means this would get cancelled out. So I would be having d cube, and the answer of d cube is, it is 140.37 into 10 raised to 3. Therefore, if I take the cube root sign, I would be getting capital D is equal to 128 mm. That's the outer diameter for hollow shaft. Next, I'll say that since small d is equal to 0.6 times of capital D, therefore 0.6 into 128. So here I have small d value as 76.8 mm. Once I have capital D and small d, now I can easily calculate the percentage saving in weight. I can say that since percentage saving in weight is equal to area of solid shaft minus area of hollow shaft upon area of solid shaft into 100. Therefore, area of solid shaft, it would be given by pi by 4 d square. Here I'll write down d suffix s, it represents the diameter of solid shaft, minus pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square. This is for hollow shaft, outer diameter and internal diameter. Divide this by pi by 4 ds square, that is the diameter of solid shaft, into 100. If I see from all the terms, I can take pi by 4 common and cancel it out. Diameter of solid shaft, we know that it is 122.18. The diameter, outer diameter of hollow shaft, that was 128. And small diameter, it was the inner diameter, it was 76.8. So from this, I would be getting the percentage saving in weight. And the value comes out to be 29.76%, which is close to 30%. It means if we prefer, instead of solid shaft, hollow shaft, then 30% weight would be saved. So here we have, I have drawn the cross section of both the solid and hollow shaft. And as we have seen, the percentage reduction in weight by using hollow shaft is 30%. So we would be preferring the cross section for hollow shaft then to the solid shaft. And with this, we complete the question.